Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I have a portable e-file from Unibeauty or Unibeauty. I'm not really sure how to say the name, so at least I tried. But anyways, they sent me their little portable e-file and some drill bits. It's like an 8-piece set of ceramic drill bits, which I'm really glad that they sent me drill bits, because I really don't like the standard drill bits that come with every single drill. But this is a really good kit for beginners, because it doesn't only come with a drill, it comes with a bunch of other stuff you need to file your nails. And I'm gonna go ahead and take everything out and show you exactly what comes in the kit. So here are the drill bits that come with the kit. I do like the man drill bit all the way on the far right. I use that for nail prep a lot, with the sanding bands at the top, and those work really good. I'm not really a fan of the other diamond bits though. And this is the rose gold handpiece. It's really nice and lightweight. You plug it in at the bottom, and here is the little plug, which I'll be plugging it in a few to show you guys that. And you also do get a little cuticle pusher to push back your cuticles, which I thought was really nice. You don't normally get stuff like that with a nail drill. And then you get a little tiny 100-180 grit nail file, and then a bunch of sanding bands in different sizes. And you also do get like a little instruction manual that just shows you how to like operate the drill and stuff like that, and it comes in different languages. And here are the drill bits. This literally comes with like every drill bit you need. They have like fine grit, extra fine grit, even these two little cuticle bits. I'm going to try to show you guys how to use like as many of these as I can in the video. Obviously I'm not going to be able to show all of them, but I will be showing most of them for the most part. This here is a little cleaning brush to dust off your nails. Then you have extra fine grit to like, you know, finish filing. And the medium grit, you can use this to like remove gel polishes. And the coarse bit is for like removing product. Along with the extra coarse bit, you can also use this to like remove product. And then you have a fine grit drill bit that you can use to finish filing as well. And the good thing about ceramic drill bits is that you can use them with acrylic or poly gel, and then they don't heat up as much on your nail. Like, they have really good heat dissipation, so you don't have to worry about them getting really hot, and they're way easier to clean and stuff. I've actually been using a few ceramic drill bits lately, and I've been liking them a lot, so I'm really happy I got this set. And plus, they are all safety bits too, so you don't have to worry about like cutting yourself, especially if you're like a beginner and you're new to doing nails. You always want to get like a safety bit. You don't want to get like a bit that is not a safety bit, because you have more of a chance of like cutting yourself, and trust me, you don't want to do that because it hurts. So I'm gonna go ahead now and plug in this nail drill, and I'm gonna just demonstrate with one of the bits. All you have to do is stick the bit right down in there. And these bits, the size is the standard size, 3 by 32, so they'll fit in like any nail drill, these drill bits. But yeah, basically there's a button that you push up to go forward, and you push it down to go in reverse. And then there's a speed control button from 0 to 20,000 RPMs. And overall, I really like the drill. It's really low vibration and it's not noisy at all, and it works really well. So I'm gonna go ahead and start the tutorial. I'm gonna do a set of nails on my practice hand, and then I will finish filing with this nail drill so I can demonstrate some of the drill bits for you guys. So I'm doing like a quick little poly gel design. I did apply some full cover nails to my practice hand and shape them up off camera. And now I'm going in with Mia Secret dehydrator and this No Lift Nails nail primer. I use that primer on my practice hand, but normally I use Young Nails Protein Bond, but I save that for my nails. I just use like any primer really on my practice hand. And I'm going in with a base gel from McCart. I'm using mostly some poly gel from the McCart Pink Poly Gel Kit. And you're gonna wanna cure that for 60 seconds. And what this base gel is going to do is just give that poly gel something to stick to and protect the natural nail. I'm kind of treating this as if it was like a real person. These are the same steps that you would follow. So after that, I'm gonna be going in with this jelly polish called Sweet Pink from one of the McCart jelly polish kits. And I'll be sure to leave the links to all the products I'm using in the description box, along with my discount code. If you guys were interested in those, I have an affiliate code with McCart. It's StayPolish91. If you guys ever shop there, you can save 15%. So yeah, after that, I cure in my lamp for 60 seconds. Now I'm going in with this glitter gel from Nay Jolie. It's in the number AB12. It's like a glitter gel polish, but the consistency is kind of like a builder in a bottle in a way. It's really thick. So yeah, I'm just applying that to the top part of the nail. And then I'm gonna be taking my gel brush and kind of like fading it down into the jelly color to kind of like do like a glitter ombre fade in a way. And then I just add in more glitter if I need to. But the reason why I applied the pink jelly polish first is because that glitter gel polish has like a pinkish tint to it, and I wanted to bring more of that pink tint out because I wanted the set of nails to be like just like strictly pink. I didn't want any other colors popping through. So yeah, that's why I did that. So I'm gonna continue to do this, and then I'll be flash curing with my mini McCart UV LED lamp here and there, because sometimes I end up like hitting my hand on the gel. Now I'm gonna go ahead and encapsulate all of the nails with this pink poly gel from McCart in the number 382. This is from the pink poly gel kit, like I said before. This one is pretty translucent. So yeah, even though it's pink, you'll still be able to see the glitter through it. That's why I chose it, because I wanted, like, you know, them to be more pink. And it does still give it that jelly look, which I really liked. And this set really reminded me of, like, confetti. That's why I decided to call it that. I just love the way they came out. Like, they're really simple but really cute at the same time. So yeah, the way I encapsulate is I just, like, squeeze out the poly gel, like, already in the form, and basically all I do is pat it in place. I always start by the cuticle. That's the best thing you could do with poly gel. Start by the cuticle and work your way side to side down the nail until you get to the free edge, and you can kind of, like, brush the poly gel down. And I do remove the excess poly gel with the spatula, and the reason I add a little bit more is because I like to do long nails and you need more product for longer nails. So yeah, I'm gonna do that and flash cure with my mini lamp.
Thank you.
All right, so now I'm going in with a second layer of the pink poly gel just to give the nails some more thickness since they're pretty long and I wanted them to be a little bit thicker because they're kind of thin. I also did cure in my big lamp for 60 seconds before I went in with this second layer to make sure that the poly gel is fully cured. Okay, so moving on to the filing, I did cleanse the nails off camera with some nail cleanser, and I'm using the medium grit bit right now on a medium speed, and as you can see, it takes off the product pretty fast with little pressure on a low speed. So you could imagine how much more product you would remove if you were on a higher speed. You can use this bit to remove gel polish or like, you know, debulk the nails. If you made them a little bit thicker, you can debulk with this. And then the next drill bit I'm gonna be going in with is the coarse drill bit. And as you can see on a lower speed with this one, it does take down a lot of product. So yeah, you can use this to remove poly gel from your nails or acrylic. On a higher speed, you would take down more product, but as you can see on this medium speed, it is taking down quite a bit of product. I'm using the bits on a medium speed just because I don't want to file too much off of the nails because I don't want them to end up way too thin, but you get the point. And now I'm going in with the fine grit bit. This bit is like a finished filing bit. If you don't apply the product too thick after you're done doing your nails, you can finish filing with this bit. It's also good for gel because gel files down faster than acrylic. So it's a little more gentle. You won't file as much product down if you use a fine grit bit. The next drill bit I'm going in with will be the extra coarse bit. I'm usually so scared of these kind of bits. Like, I'm always scared that I'm gonna cut my finger or something, but this one is actually pretty gentle compared to most extra coarse drill bits that I've tried. Like, I actually feel really comfortable using it. And you can go up and down with the drill, or you can go side to side, whichever way you feel comfortable with. I always debulk the sides of the nails as well. You're gonna wanna go around the cuticle, and then you can go side to side to smooth out the nail, like all the way down the nail. The shape of your nail should be like, the sidewall should be thin. You should have that hill, which is your apex, and then the free edge should be thinner than the rest of the nail, but not too thin where it's going to break. So I'm just gonna finish filing. Next, I'm taking that mandrel bit with a fine grit sanding band, and I'm going around the cuticles because sometimes you can't get really close to the cuticle with those safety bits. So I go in with the sanding band to like help seal around the cuticle a little more. But after this, I do go in with one of the cuticle bits to do a final seal. But this just helps to like debulk better around the cuticle because, like I said, those safety bits have that guard. So yeah, there's three types of sanding bands you can use. There's a fine grit, a medium grit, and a coarse grit. And obviously the more coarse you use, the more product you're gonna take down. So I'm using the fine grit to do that. And I also flip the hand over and file underneath the nail to get out any like excess nail tip, because sometimes when I shape up my nail tips, I get that little plastic piece on the side. And I just end up filing it off in the end because like it's kind of annoying sometimes sitting there trying to peel it off when you just want to get to work. And I do like file if there might have been any poly gel that might have gotten stuck under there. And now I'm gonna go in with one of those cuticle bits, and this is how I finish sealing around the cuticle. You want to do these two bits on a low speed. You do not want to use a high speed around the cuticle because you'll cause like indentations in your nail, or you'll cause like them to heat up and you'll get like rings of fire. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and shape up the nails with my hand file. I'm using one of my own hand files because the hand file that came with the kit is really small. That's more if you want to use it on your natural nails. Obviously that's not going to work with these really long nails. So I'm using a 100 180 grit nail file, and I'm doing a coffin shape. So I usually file a few times straight on each side, and then I angle my file in and file a few times on each side to get the coffin shape. And I do go in with my buffer after I'm done shaping up the nails. And sorry that these stupid nails keep like sliding out because they're not glued in. I do have to think of another way to get these to stay on. Maybe some tack or something. But right now I don't glue my practice hand nails on because I don't want them to damage the silicone, because that's what the glue does. It damages the silicone if you glue them on. I also do flip the hand over to shape up the nails, because sometimes when you're looking at them straight on, you think they're straight, and then when you flip them over they're actually not. So you can just line the nails up that way and shape them up. I always make the pointer, middle, and ring finger the same length, the pinky a little bit shorter, and then the thumb I always make slightly longer. And I do buff over the surface just to get out any scratches before I go to top coat. To finish the design, I'm just gonna go ahead and top coat all the nails with this McCart top gel from their pink poly gel kit. And I am top coating the underside of the nails because sometimes you get those little like buffing scratches, and top coating underneath the nail helps like mask that so you don't see it and everything looks nice and glossy and jelly. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this set, guys. It was really simple and easy, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. But before you go, make sure you guys have your notifications turned on, because I will be hosting a giveaway on my channel Tuesday. So make sure you have your notifications on so you guys can enter. And if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload a new video. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I'll see you guys in my next one.